Hi everyone. In this tutorial, we will create a smooth scroll animation with GSAP ScrollTrigger. The images will move in a diagonal direction. The text will scroll continuously across the screen. We will also add a colorful particle effect in the background. Everything will work in a responsive design. Let's get started. Let's begin with the HTML. Inside the section, we have a heading for the moving text. There are 6 images, but you can add more if you want. Finally, we add a container for the background particles. Now let's move on to the CSS. In this part, we will style the images, text, and particles to prepare them for animation. We use this font for the text. We reset the margins, paddings, and box sizing for all elements. The section covers the full width and height of the screen. We create a background using a radial gradient to highlight the text and images. The background will look like this. The text is styled with a transparent fill and a visible stroke. All images are absolutely positioned so we can move them freely with GSAP. The particle container is fixed in place so particles can move anywhere on the screen. We also make each particle a circle. The fade keyframe animation makes particles softly appear and disappear. After creating animations, we'll return to the CSS to add media queries. In this part, we will animate the images, text, and particles. Now we add the CDN links to use GSAP and ScrollTrigger. This plugin enables ScrollTrigger animations. We select all images and the text. We create a GSAP timeline with ScrollTrigger. The animation starts when the section enters view. We adjust the scroll length based on the number of images. We set the scrub value for a smooth scroll effect. Pinning keeps the section fixed while the animation plays. The images move in X and Y directions with a small rotation of negative 30 degrees. Stagger makes images move one after another. This is how far the text should move to exit the screen from the left. We create another GSAP timeline that repeats forever. We set the ease to linear so the speed stays constant. The text moves from right to left across the screen. When it finishes, we reset its position and start again. For now, I disable the text animation so it doesn't distract you. Now we create the particle animation. We select the particle container and define the colors. We create 150 small div elements for particles. It gets a random size between 3 pixels and 10 pixels. Now we style each particle. It has the same width and height. It gets a random position on the screen. It has a random color from the array colors. Its animation lasts for a random amount of time. Actually, this animation appears above the images. Let me increase the size of the images so you can see how it looks. If you increase the z-index of the images, the particle animation will appear behind them. Now we add media queries to make the design responsive, so the animation works better on smaller screens. We adjust the image size and text stroke on smaller screens. The last image doesn't fully disappear at the end of the scroll. To fix this, we create a function that sets movement distances based on screen size. This way, the images will disappear in the bottom right corner on small screens. And there you have it. The images move diagonally in sequence when we scroll. The text also scrolls continuously across the screen. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more creative projects. Thanks for watching.